What up, little chef? Oh, we got Chef Burke in the house. What up, buddy?
What up?
Look at that chef jacket. All right, what up, Elaine? And then we got Chef Ada and Chef Hannah. All right, who's Hannah?
Oh, hello, Chef Hannah.
Hi, Hannah. I like your Christmas tree. That's very nice.
Oh, and welcome, Chef Ada, over there.
Amazing. And you guys are welcome to be off mute here.
Oh, yeah, and we got Ishmael over here.
We got Ishmael. And then we had one other friend that was signed up for this from the class.
That's Aida.
Oh, that's Aida?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay.
Aida, Annalie, right. And Burke. And then you know.
Aida, Annalie, and Burke. And then we got Chef Elaine. Elaine, how are you doing?
Good.
All right. Elaine just started a new position. This is a little bit of a celebration gift for her. We invited a bunch of people in the class, and then they were like, are we actually doing this? And I said, yeah, we're doing this.
I was like, oh, for real? Oh, it's happening. Okay.
It's cooking and nog time.
Cooking and nog time. So Jeremy's going to walk you guys through how to make the most incredible cookies and eggnog you could ever imagine.
Oh, yes. Yes. It's a great...
They don't like eggnog at all.
They don't like eggnog.
Well, have you ever had homemade eggnog?
It's what?
What did you say, Hannah?
My brother Rocco does.
Your brother Rocco likes it?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, you can make some for Rocco, okay? Is that okay, Hannah?
Yeah.
Okay, good. That's very
I like your fake chef hat.
It's real. See? I can't even push through it because it's so real. Oh, it just keeps changing. Oh.
No, yeah. You look...
You have a flower in your hair. What's your
girl? The last one, you looked like a cyclops.
I knew I was like a cyclops alien. Now I'm a little sharky guy.
Stop being a shark.
Ooh.
You cool new.
Cool glasses on now.
That one's my favorite. They see me rolling.
Okay, that looks too cool.
Is it cookie time over there, Hannah?
Hmm?
Is it cookie time?
No.
It's not
no?
cookie time?
Yes, it is.
Yes!
Time is cookie time.
Yeah!
Yeah,
it's cookie time.
Some cookies?
Yep.
Awesome. I think we'll get right into it.
Again.
I got my chef hat on. It's a good way to go. You should have your chef
you
hat on.
You just went under it.
What?
You just went under it. Now you're under it again.
Oh no! Okay. Well, we'll get right into our cookies. Oh yeah. See, it's nice. You can't knock off the chef
hat. Ghost hat. It's a ghost hat.
Yeah.
It's a ghost hat?
Yeah.
Oh yes, it is my little ghost hat. And so, I just got out of a meeting with Santa and he said we need to make some cookies today. It is a very important thing to have some delicious cookies. Do we all agree?
Yes!
Okay, we're going to get right started on these. Yes, we're going to get right started on our cookies today. And so I want you to go ahead, pull out your stick of butter. Yes.
But I have my stick.
Oh, we've got enough for two batches of cookie over there.
Yep.
We're going to make some serious amount of cookies.
And Ismael, how many cookie batches?
Can I take it out?
One batch, we got two batches.
Oh, we need a bowl?
Yes, you need a bowl over here.
Can I get the butter out now?
Yeah, so we get the butter out, and we're going to put our butter into our bowl over here.
Okay.
We want our butter to be nice and soft, so if it's not soft, you may want to pop it in the microwave for a few minutes.
Oh, okay.
We're not ready yet.
Hold on.
About 10 or so seconds.
We are not ready.
Guys, we got it. We got two batches, so we're gonna make. We got to get another bowl, so it's okay.
We need two batches.
We can just stick
if you do two batches. You can do it all in one bowl and just do one big batch in the bowl.
One big bowl, okay, guys.
Ooh, yeah. You just need one.
It's a pepper.
Oh, it's fine. Don't worry, it's not metal.
And yeah, we just want about 10 seconds on that butter to soften it up. You want your butter to be nice and soft.
How big a bowl do we need? Like medium?
Like a medium sized bowl? So maybe a little bit bigger. If you have one bigger than that, Ismail, you'll be good to go. The other thing I want to do.
We're almost ready.
Preheat my oven to 350 right now. That is going to be our ideal cookie baking temperature. That butter, we want it nice and soft so it's spreadable. That's going to make it easier to break down as we bring these cookies together. And the other thing I'm going to pull out is my bag of sugar. And so while our butter's warming up, we can look at our sugar. We've got a few bags of sugar. There's a bigger bag of sugar and a smaller bag of sugar. Or could we use the big bag of sugar?
Big bag of sugar.
Yeah.
We need two. Okay, those are the two big bags. Here's the butter.
No idea what you.
What do you guys?
And that's just going to go in our bowl with our butter.
Okay, go ahead and put the butter in the bowl, Burke, or whoever.
Okay.
Bye. And so that large bag of sugar is in my bowl with my butter. And we just want to cream this together.
Okay, so what's the first bag? Who has the butter?
I'll do the, I'll do the first. I'll do
this
the
one. That's larger. Let me see that one, Hannah. Let me see. These two are the large.
I'll put in one.
Okay, both of you. Somebody, one person.
Yeah,
the other person took the other bag.
And we just want to get that sugar in and work it in.
Hold on.
Our butter. Oh, yeah. You got time. Don't worry, chefs.
I'm trying to open it.
If I want to use a stand mixer, do I just throw it in there?
Yeah, you can just throw it in the stand.
I brought a whole bag.
You have a paddle attachment on your stand mixer.
Oh, I'm going to make them. We're using the bigger bowl, so my stand mixer has like a.
Oh, yes. Yeah. And this comes together
your really turn.
By hand or in the mixer. You can use whichever you
like. By hand, guys. All right. Okay, so that, see what he's doing?
And so you're just going to want to mix until that sugar and butter come together and form a nice paste.
Let's do it all together.
Here, let me give you a spatula. Just relax.
And again, our oven's at around 350, so we can have a nice bake on those cookies. Okay. And then doing it in the stand mixer, you just want to make sure occasionally as that butter's going in, you scrape down the sides of your bowl so everything gets nice and evenly incorporated in there.
You cut yourself?
No.
Okay. And so, after a few seconds of mixing, you should have a nice paste forming over here.
Okay. Let me see, Hannah. Go ahead, Burke. Nice. Okay.
Once we're seeing that nice paste, we can get those next two ingredients ready to go on deck. Even if we're not seeing it, we want to grab our molasses jar and our whole eggs.
Okay. Both molasses and both.
Because
we're doing
it
better. Okay.
Here, you take the eggs. I also take another one.
And so once it's nice and well combined, I like to start getting my molasses in there.
Okay, let's get our molasses.
Go ahead, guys. I can combine it more as you put the molasses in.
Yeah, combining.
Okay, here. You want me now? Or your butter made it separate? It's okay.
Yeah. And they are hard to unscrew, so don't worry. They are pretty hard to unscrew. But we'll just scrape all of that molasses in here.
Okay, let's. Okay.
And the molasses is going to give this really nice flavor. It's also going to give these cookies a nice chewiness. So it'll have that really chewy, good cookie going on. Anytime you add a liquid sugar into your cookie, it gives it really good chewiness. So whether it's corn syrup, the molasses, a little bit of honey, it's all going to add chewiness to your cookie.
I haven't mixed in the molasses yet, but is this mixed enough before adding the molasses, or should I mix it up more?
That'll be okay. The butter still looks like it's just a hair cold, so as you add the molasses in there, it'll start forming more of a paste and it'll come together.
Okay, so I should add the molasses now?
Yeah, add the molasses now. That sugar and butter, the main thing is on that first step, we want the sugar and butter coming together, and they look like they're nice and well combined in there. The warmer your butter is, the more of a whole paste it forms. If your butter is like a cold, it'll kind of be a little crumbly.
All the molasses in there, but
going in with that molasses, we're just gonna mix and it'll just come together. And you'll get this nice creamy paste going on.
Oh, let's see.
Good.
Let me stir it. Okay, that's okay.
I'll help.
Ooh, yeah. That's looking like it's coming together. And the molasses will just swirl in beautifully.
Hey, Brooke, you want to make it look like, see how there's this, like, all down?
Mm-hmm.
And so, I like to know, do we have any favorite holiday songs over there?
We have another chef.
Who has a favorite holiday song?
I do. I have a favorite holiday song.
Burke, what is your favorite song?
My favorite song is Have a Holly Jolly Christmas by Michael Bublé.
Ooh, okay.
All I Want for Christmas is You.
Okay, we'll get both of those going. Okay, I got a little music for everyone over here.
We want to put all the molasses in there?
Yeah, all the molasses. And if there's just like a little bit left behind on the jar, you don't have to worry about that, but scoop most of it, as much as you can get into there.
Oh. Did we need to put the egg yolk in there too, or just the molasses?
Just the molasses so far.
Mix.
Okay. Have a holly jolly Christmas, and when you walk down...
Once our molasses is nice and well combined, that's when we're going to go in with our egg yolks on this. Or not our egg yolks, our whole egg, pardon me. Our whole egg is going in. We're saving our egg yolk for later.
Okay,
Yeah! Yeah, that's looking great over there. Perfect. Yeah, that is pretty beautifully.
Go ahead and put the egg yolk in there now?
The whole egg.
Okay.
Yeah, so both whole eggs will go in once you have a nice creamy mixture with that molasses.
Do we want it to be creamier than this before adding the egg, or?
Give it another 30 seconds on like a medium high speed and then go in with the egg, but that's looking right on track. So like 30 seconds on medium high, Ismail, and you'll be good to go.
Gotcha.
Okay. Go ahead and put that in, huh?
Somebody waits for you.
And you want to mix till it gets well combined in there. If the like butter or the egg was a little cold, it may split a little bit and you may have little graininess in there. As the flour mixture goes in, we'll be a-okay on that.
Alright, can I mix it now?
And so, yeah, give it a little elbow grease. We're going medium to medium high. Ismail, I'm going to guess that yours is ready to go now. It just needed that extra 30 seconds, and the egg should be good to go in there.
All
right. Give me this. Yeah. And so the eggs are going to soften this and bring it together really, really nicely.
Sorry, guys.
Come on. This is the egg we want, right?
Yes, that's the right one. Just the whole eggs. We'll use the yolks in our eggnog.
Santa
everybody. Ismail, are you a fan of eggnog over there?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, good, good, good. And I promise, to anyone who does not like eggnog, this is going to be the best kind of eggnog you've ever had. I know. Hannah, I know we're raising our hand, we're saying no to the eggnog. You'll just have to try a little bit of this one, okay, Chef?
Okay, guys.
Okay.
You put some whiskey in there and put you guys to sleep. Just kidding.
You were on mute. We didn't hear any of that. Yeah. And so it'll come together and it'll look nice and creamy. We want something that looks fairly creamy.
Okay, this is looking like a pretty liquidy, like,
I'll be right back.
That looks good over there at Team
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, that'll be okay. As the flour goes in, it'll firm up just a little bit.
Okay.
Flour! I'll get the flour. I get the flour.
Yeah. And then, is it kind of smoothing out as those eggs are incorporating in there?
Yeah, it's like really smooth and it's like super creamy. A little bit grainy, but still like creamy.
But yeah, it'll be grainy until like the very end. Once we add the flour, bake it off, it'll start losing a little bit of that graininess. And so the thing about this is the more you mix it, kind of the fluffier it's gonna get, the lighter it's gonna get. That's just the aeration during the creaming process.
Okay.
And so we do want to grab our bag of flour.
Okay. Guys got it?
Mm-hmm. I want to see what it looks like when the flour is
in. We have it.
And we want to remove a half cup from each bag of flour. And we'll just set that half cup aside. So,
there we go.
I'm just removing a half cup, setting a half cup aside.
My Christmas tree. It's a snowman.
It feels a little grainy, maybe not too, kind of liquidy also.
Oh, it's looking right. And so what happens is sometimes if it was like, if you keep it stirring another few seconds, it'll come together, but it'll never have that, the sugar grains will not really fully dissolve in this.
Okay.
So, yeah, looking at that, you'll have that sugar graininess, the egg will combine in there. Give it another few seconds of mixing as you mix up the flour, and once the flour's mixed up, it'll be ready to go. So you can move on the flour with us, let the mixer mix it up, and then once the flour's ready, you'll be ready to add.
Okay, so I can go in with the flour now?
Yeah, you can go in with the flour. You can keep it mixed for another few seconds while we get our flour ready. And so with our flour...
Okay.
And so, yeah, just keep it on a medium speed while we prepare our flour. So we're taking our bag of flour, removing our half cup over here, setting that half cup aside. In the bag of flour, I want to add a few things. We've got all of our spices, so we've got our cinnamon, our cardamom, our ginger, our allspice, and our baking soda.
Just like that. All these. Okay.
And we want to start adding that in with our flour.
The baking soda.
Yeah, so all of our little ground spice packets plus the baking soda.
The ginger, baking soda, cardamom. You have cardamom?
And cinnamon and allspice.
I have ginger.
Anna
has ginger.
And so.
And I eat it. Okay, go ahead.
Go ahead. We've removed that half cup of flour from our bag. And now we're going in with our allspice. Our cinnamon.
Wait, which one did you do? Ginger?
Who has ginger? This is
ginger. Okay, another ginger.
All of the spice packets are going in, so we're going in allspice, cinnamon, we're going in ginger, we're going in cardamom, and we're going in baking soda.
Which one's the allspice? Is it this? Hold on.
Allspice is a little bit darker.
Oh.
Which one is it? Is it
I don't see it.
I don't see it. Is this it?
That's a truffle salt.
That's truffle salt. Okay. Do you have allspice?
Sorry, are we mixing this into this bowl or into a separate bowl?
I've got it in this Ziploc bag together. So I removed that half cup of flour from my bag of flour, and now all my spices are going in with that remaining flour.
Oh, you put it in this bag?
Is that?
Yeah, I don't like using an extra bowl. I like to save on my bowl. So I'm going right into the bag.
I don't think we got allspice.
If there's no allspice, it may be like stuck in the box. Sometimes those little bags stick in the box on like the insulation or the packing. If there's no allspice, it is totally fine. You can grate a little bit of nutmeg into there.
Oh, we have nutmeg.
Oh yeah, you could go in with nutmeg. You could go in with any spices. Cloves are really good in there.
What's the nutmeg?
Yeah. Come on.
Can I put baking soda in there?
Cinnamon. You love nutmeg. We've got that fresh nutmeg. We can grate some of that fresh nutmeg in here. And that's not in the recipe. That's just an optional fun way to kind of add some extra flavor.
Okay. So we got the nutmeg. We didn't get the allspice.
Which one do I pick the nutmeg?
Okay, just wait. The grape bag. All of the spices in there that you have.
Yeah. And so one more time, in this bag with my flour minus a half cup, we've got our cinnamon, our nut, our allspice, our ginger, our cardamom, and our baking soda. The last thing we want to go in with is a teaspoon of our little packet of truffle salt. Just to add a little salty kick. You don't have to use truffle salt, you can use regular salt. But I like that little truffly essence in there. So just a teaspoon of that truffle salt to get a little saltiness in these cookies.
Yeah.
And then we'll go ahead, zip this up, give it a little bit of a shake. And so we just want to give that bag a little bit of a shake to get everything nice and well combined. Yes, perfect. And so, are we feeling good about our spice flour out there? Thumbs up if you're feeling good. Ooh. And then our spiced flour is just gonna go in with our creamed butter mixture. And Ismail, is the butter and sugar looking a little bit smoother in there now that you've had it going for a minute?
I actually stopped it from going. Maybe I should I have left it just running? Would that? Oh. I was worried it'd be too creamy.
If you stopped it, it's totally fine. This can be mixed a ton, it can be mixed a little bit. It's a very forgiving batter, so you'll be good to go. Yeah. So we just want that nice creaminess. And then we're going in with our bags of flour. And so after you've shaken for a minute, go in with all of that floury goodness. And we're just gonna mix to combine.
Nutmeg.
Oh yeah. You're welcome to grate a little nutmeg in.
Yeah,
ooh, good, good, good. Yeah, I love a little nutmeg.
Okay, so we put go ahead guys, put it all in. I'm gonna mix while you guys put it in. Go ahead.
Wait, you're okay. You're okay. Don't worry, you're not missing anything.
Oh yeah. Yeah, we put all the flour in. And once it comes together and forms a nice dough ball, it is ready to go.
Ooh, where'd you get that?
No.
Not yet. That's for the. That's for your favorite drink, eggnog. Like what?
Ooh, yes.
Just give me a laugh. Come on, a little bit more holiday spirit.
It comes together as a fairly stiff dough, but once it's kind of absorbed all that flour, your cookie dough is ready to go.
Oh, sorry.
I'll be good with my gingerbread house.
Oh, God. Let's talk about that.
And this cookie dough is not the dough you want to make a gingerbread house. There's like multiple kinds of gingerbread. There's like structural gingerbread, which is a little firmer. This is a much softer, chewier dough. Oh.
Oh, Kevin, he made a gingerbread that those gingerbread houses that you can buy at like Trader Joe's.
Ooh.
It's like a pre-made gingerbread. You build a cookie.
Adrian was here yesterday.
Ooh, I'm excited. This weekend is my, like, gingerbread village assembly weekend, so I'm going to try to make a few gingerbread houses, have the village of gingerbread houses.
What?
Whoa.
It's so fun! I like to do it so I have a big house and then some smaller houses around it, because I've got this mini cutter that makes houses that are about this big. They're, like, bite-sized gingerbread houses.
But those houses are probably going to be delicious.
That
the pre-made Trader Joe one.
That one in from Trader Joe's can probably fit. Not it can't fit in a lion's mouth. The whole thing can fit in a hippopotamus.
It could fit in a hippopotamus. Yeah, Ismail, that's looking really good over there. Yeah. Yes, and Auntie Wendy's perfect, perfect, perfect. And so this dough is ready to scoop and bake. And so. There's two ways you can do it. You can chill it and then cut it out and kind of make some cutout cookies, or you can bake.
I'll do the ninja cookies.
Oh, wait, but you're saying to chill it?
So, we're gonna go ahead, scoop and bake some and do some round cookies so we can have cookies immediately.
Okay.
If you wanna do cutout cookies, you gotta chill the dough for about an hour. So, it's up to you if you wanna do that. But I'm gonna just show you how to do the first scoop and bake one.
You guys, we will do cutouts, but wait, just relax.
Did you add nutmeg?
I grated just a little nutmeg in. If you want a little nutmeg, you can grate it in. It's not like part of the recipe, but I love nutmeg, so I went in with a little bit. The nutmeg is mainly for the eggnog. But if you want, you can grate some in right now, add in that little extra flavor if you like nutmeg a lot. Nutmeg because you get a lot of extra flavor from it. So if you grated it on top, blend it in.
So do you have to cut the nutmeg before using it? I haven't used nutmeg.
So you just go right on your microplane and grate it and it'll be good to go.
All right.
It's pretty cool. It's super fragrant too. And I just do a few grates, you know, just about a quarter teaspoon on there because it's super aromatic, super pungent.
All right, I don't know how much I just added, but...
Yeah, it's just like the little kiss. It's more for the eggnog over here. And I never measure my nutmeg. I just kind of grate till things look good, smell good.
It's already mixed enough, this thing. But what we're going to do is...
So did you say we're ready to start making these balls?
Yeah, so we can go ahead. Once we've got our nice dough formed, you can go in and scoop little golf ball sized cookie dough pieces.
Wait, wash your hands. I don't know what else you touched.
Okay, we can wash our
hands. Wash it again. Wash your hands again.
It's like sticking to your hands. You can go in with a little bit of that remaining flour and kind of just put it on your hands. And then just kind of pull little golf ball sized pieces, balls, and roll them into little cookie dough balls. And I'm just going to place them right on a parchment-lined sheet tray. And golf ball is just like a rough estimate. These are a little smaller or a little larger. It is totally fine. You can use a cookie scoop for them as well if you have a cookie scoop. How's it tasting over there? Okay, good. We got the thumbs up. It is tasting good.
Alright, that's good. Oh man, I'm just gonna eat all this now.
Well, honestly, like, if you stop right here and just eat cookies, I can blame you. It's my favorite little treat.
And so, we're gonna make some of these, and then we're gonna refrigerator, and then do the cookie cutter ones, okay?
Okay. Okay, I get it. Oh, wait, look, here's the allspice. I just found it. You just found the allspice?
Oh, if you found the allspice, you can add it in right now. You can kind of coat the cookie.
She just found it.
So, how big are we making these?
I go about golf ball size.
I don't play a lot of golf, so.
I don't. Okay. I would say about a tablespoon and a half. I don't do much golf. Ping pong ball size.
Okay, that seems like what I have. Okay.
Yeah, you could go a little bit more on there if you want. I have made so many of these cookies, so I've got an example of sizing.
Okay, what do you
want to
say, bro?
And then do we need to flatten them out or just put the balls down?
Yeah, and I'll show you how to flatten them. Yeah, so we make our little balls. And then once you've got the balls made, you want them about 2 inches apart because they'll spread a lot. And I'm just going to take a glass, dip it in my flour, and then press with that floured glass to flatten my cookie.
Okay, so here's this.
Oh, you just want them to be about a quarter inch.
Make
a half inch thick on those cookies.
Good. Okay. See how small. See this.
Chef Burke, did you have a question over there?
Yes.
What's your question?
My question was, what happens when you add the nutmeg and the allspice?
Okay.
Oh, it's just a little more flavor in there.
Oh.
Yeah. So just a little extra flavor going on in there.
Come on. Here. Or you can just take it.
Okay, I'll take
like little balls. Okay, take it all. You guys you wash your hands again.
And so if you have a cookie scoop, you can use a cookie scoop too. However you want to do it. And if you want, you can have a little taste of the cookie dough. That's a big part. But only okay if it's okay with mom over there. And so we'll scoop and roll some of our cookie dough balls.
Not too big, though.
How do I get my glass to pick up the dough?
Thanks for like... Okay, here. Let's
go. If you kind of press your glass into the cookie dough that's in the bowl.
Hold on. I'm going to give you another tray. Hold on, guys.
And then once it has that little bit of fat on there, it'll hold the flour a little bit.
Yeah.
Is that working?
Yeah, it's working.
Okay, perfect. And the other thing, if you like sugar better, you can also dip in a little bit of sugar and get that like sugared top so it's got that little crispiness on top.
Can you show me how you flatten them again?
Yeah, let me grab one more tray. And so, I've got my cookie dough balls on the tray. I dip into that flour and then just gently press. And sometimes it sticks to the glass. If it sticks to the glass, you just use your finger to kind of peel it off. But just a gentle press. Kind of flattened.
We don't have to use all the cookie dough, guys. Remember, we want to get the cookie cutter later.
And again, I'm keeping about a 2-inch border around them so that they don't spread into each other.
I'm just going to wash my hands.
Okay, guys, I'm sorry, I like this a little too big. Okay, we're going to put Here, gotta put some space in between.
And so we've got our nice tray of cookies going. And again, just that glass to smash. And it does stick sometimes, that's just part of the game of the cookies. And if as you're rolling this, the dough is like too sticky for your hands, you can use a little flour on your hands to kind of decrease the stickiness over there. Ooh, yeah! I'm seeing some good cookie dough balls out there. And so I love these as the round cookies. If you are wanting to do cutout cookies where you use the cookie cutters.
Maybe three more.
I'll get the glass.
And you want to wrap the remaining dough in a little plastic wrap and just form it into like a half inch disc. The half inch thickness will give you a really nice roll for it. So, and you'll chill it in the fridge for an hour or the fridge for about 15 minutes.
That's fine. You just dip the bottom into that bowl.
What are we chilling?
The bottom. Oh,
so this is only if you want to do cutout cookies, like with cookie cutters.
Oh, gotcha. You
can fill any excess dough.
Is this enough?
Otherwise,
yes.
Once we have our like nice cookies and they're pressed out with that glass, we can pop these into the oven.
Bye.
And so we're gonna give those cookies a little press down, and then we're going right in our 350 degree oven with these. And so Israel, how are the cookies looking? We got a nice press on there.
Yeah, let me show you.
Oh yeah. Those look phenomenal. Yeah, those look great. It'll be around 12 on the tray. So yeah, that's looking good. And then just dip your glass in the flour as you're pressing, and you'll have a really nice cookie going on.
I have another question.
Yes, yeah, Chef Burke.
My other question is,
what? Here.
You used the glass. And when
I tried using the glass, and it didn't work. Don't worry.
So you want to make sure you dip that glass in the flour, and it'll kind of help keep it from sticking. And even with a little flour on the glass, sometimes the glass will still stick.
Okay, I'll see.
Are we getting some nice press on the cookies now?
Yes.
Okay, perfect. And so once we've pressed out a tray, we're going to go ahead, pop these in our oven, and they'll bake around 10 to 12 minutes. And so we'll get our first tray in the oven, and we'll get like a 10 minute timer going over here.
It's the same.
And if you don't want to bake off all the cookies today, they do save really well as cookie dough balls. So you can make nice cookie dough balls, save them in the fridge, and bake them off fresh throughout the week. You can also bake them off or save them in the freezer for even longer. And so, the last thing we're finishing up over here is going to be our eggnog. Yeah, and those are looking good over there. Yeah, you're doing great over there, Burke, Hannah, and Ada. Those are looking phenomenal.
Great. One more, guys. Beautiful.
So, for our eggnog, the things we want to grab our whole...
Move your chairs out of the way.
We have
10 minutes,
you said, right?
Yeah, 10 minutes in the
oven. Let's get it in the oven, flush out.
And so we'll start at 10 minutes. We may go like 12 minutes, but it's always good to check at the 10 minute mark.
No, we're moving it to the oven. Okay.
And so, the remaining thing we want to do is we want to get our eggnog ready to go. Yes, we got eggnog. So, for our eggnog.
Thank you. We'll need egg yolk, right?
We will need egg yolk, but the first thing we want to do, we want to grab our containers of milk and get those into a saucepan on the stove.
Thanks.
So all of our milk is going in. Yeah, that's 2 cups of milk. And then we want 1 cup of cream in there.
Hold on, guys.
Can you open this?
Sorry, we're putting all of these in there?
So you're going to do the whole container of milk and then just 1 cup of the cream, so half of the cream container.
Okay.
And it's a nice balance. You don't want too much cream, otherwise it gets a little too rich. So
you said half a cup, right?
1 cup of the cream.
Oh, 1 cup of cream.
Yeah, so 1 cup of cream, the whole container of milk.
Okay, 1 cup of cream.
And so, over at...
Which bowl should we put it in?
Over at Elaine's, you can do 1 whole container of cream and both containers of milk, and that'll give you the right amount.
Well, we'll just do 1. Okay.
Yeah.
We don't know.
Yeah, so do 1 whole container of cream and both of the containers of milk over there. Each container has 2 cups of cream, and so we only need... 1 cup of cream, so just do 1 container and you'll get that right amount.
Oh, okay, so just 1 container and both milks?
Yes, 1 container of cream and both milks will get you perfect over there.
Do we want to mix these or just kind of let it
simmer? In the milk, where?
And then, I'm just going to let it simmer, so we're going to get that over a medium heat and bring it to a simmer.
Oh, watch out, Rick. Okay, are you done? Who's first?
I'm going to add my cinnamon.
Okay, go.
All right, it says add a pinch of salt. Do we add that now?
Yeah, we can add that pinch of salt right now. So,
as well as the nutmeg and the cinnamon?
Pinch of salt, our cinnamon stick, and we're going to grate in a little bit of nutmeg as well.
Okay. That's eggnog.
And the pinch of salt is just a little bit salty, it always brings out sweetness. You just want that little kiss of salt. And the nutmeg, I just grate in a few grates until I've got a nice
nutmeg on top.
And that's to your taste. If you love nutmeg, you can go in with more. If you don't like nutmeg, you can go in with less.
Okay, fine.
And so again, in my pot, I've got my milk, my cream, my cinnamon stick, a pinch of salt, and my grated nutmeg. Just a little bit of grated nutmeg.
Both cinnamon sticks or just one?
Yeah, both cinnamon sticks. Since you've got a double batch, go in with both.
Okay, go ahead and put your mouth.
And again, not too much nutmeg, right? Like I just shaved off a little bit.
Yeah, that looks just right. It's to your taste. So I went in with about 1/4 teaspoon worth, just shaving off a little bit. If you're like, I love nutmeg, you can go in with a little heavier hand on the nutmeg.
Nutmeg tastes like.
If you give nutmeg a smell, it'll kind of give you an idea of what it tastes like. So just smell it, and it smells like it tastes.
Okay, you know,
yeah. And I love using the fresh because it is so fragrant.
It smells like toothpaste.
And we have to put the truffle salt in there too. How much truffle
like
salt?
Rosemary.
Just a little pinch of it, just to bring out the sweetness. Like salty and sweet really go well together.
It kind of smells like toothpaste to me.
It
smells like rosemary.
Okay. It smells like rosemary? Ooh, we got a lot of flavors going on. And so I'm going to let this sit on my stove, come up to a simmer. I'm just on medium heat, and I'm kind of watching it as I go. I don't want anyone to have a boil over.
Look, it's Santa!
Whoa, that is coming together.
It's Santa!
Add in our sugar and our egg yolks to our bowl.
The sugar and the egg yolks?
Yeah, the sugar and the egg yolks.
Oh,
hello over there, Ismael.
He's been here the whole time, just, you know, running around our feet.
Oh, he's so precious.
Sugar.
What's his name over there?
Other sugar?
Percy.
Percy?
Yeah.
Oh, cute. And then, who is our sous chef over there, Ismael?
We have the egg yolks.
This is Ariane.
Hi. Ariane, welcome.
Next egg yolk.
Thank you. Yeah, I just got off work, so I came just in time to eat some cookie dough.
Oh, good. That is the
Can
best
when
you get home from work. It's a little extra cookie dough. Ooh, good. Well, thank you for being
Can you
here.
Pick that up, whatever that was?
Oh, thank you. Yeah, I'm excited.
Oh, you're very welcome.
Vanilla
cream. And so, in this bowl, I went in my egg yolks and my sugar, and I'm just going to stir to combine. And I like to use a whisk for this task over here. The last ingredient we have is our vanilla extract. We're not going to add our vanilla extract till the very, very end.
Not yet.
Save that vanilla for the very end. In my bowl is just our egg yolks and sugar.
Can I mix some?
And we're bringing those together. That'll be our thickening agent and our sweetener.
So yolk, sugar, and vanilla extract?
We're going to wait on the vanilla. So the vanilla is the only thing we'll have left behind. So yolks and sugar. And then the vanilla we'll add at the very end. If we add it now, it'll kind of boil out because it's alcohol based. So we'll add it at the end so we get the maximum flavor on there. And then just be cautious of your milk mixture. Make sure it doesn't boil over. It is the biggest nightmare to clean up. Okay, good, good. I see. We got eyes on it everywhere. Yeah. I have boiled over one too many pots of cream, and cleaning the stovetop is not fun.
So we're just holding on to this mixture, or do we wait till it boils or something?
Yeah, and so once our milk is at a nice simmer, we've got some steam in there, a little foaminess going on, we'll slowly add it to our egg mixture. And so I'm going to grab a ladle or a little measuring cup and just begin adding a little bit of my milk, hot milk, to my eggs. So a ladle full, giving it a little stir, then I'll go in with my next ladle full and stir until it is nice and well combined.
Not even steaming yet. I think we need to wait a little bit.
Yeah, and you do want it lightly simmering as you're doing this. So just a ladle full at a time. Once about half is in there, you can go ahead and just add your eggs back in with the hot milk mixture. And so, are we waiting for the simmer to happen over there?
Yeah, we are waiting.
Yeah.
And we're
okay. I'll wait for you guys to get that simmer going.
We're waiting for the oven.
Okay, okay. Yeah, I'll give you a minute to wait for that simmer. If you're not simmering, you can turn up the heat just a little because we've got our eyes on it now. I don't like to have it on a high heat. And then, yeah, measuring cup, ladle, anything to kind of transfer liquid.
Yes.
And then our first cookie timer is going off, so we're just going to peek on our cookies. And so on those cookies, we're looking for them to have a nice golden brown around, and they should be a little bit dry in the cracks that form. So there'll be little cracks in there. As long as they're looking dry in there, they are good to go. If they're looking super moist, you want to give them a second more in the oven. And so mine are a little moist. I want to just give them 2 more minutes to finish up.
How many ladles of milk do we put in here and then we pour it back?
Once you've got about half of it added, we'll go back into that pan. And then how are our cookies looking over there?
Almost. A couple more minutes.
Almost. Okay. So we'll give them 2 more minutes. And then are we at that simmer on our half and half or our milk?
No simmer yet. We're just getting it, actually.
Okay, perfect, perfect. And so once you've had that simmer, you've got about half of our eggs.
We need a bit more time.
Oh, you need a bit more time? Okay, okay. And so, I just incorporated half of that milk mixture, and the main thing you want to check is that it's warm on the bowl. As long as your milk mixture is getting that egg mixture warm, you're good to go back in with that half and half. And so we'll add back into the half and half. And then you just want to cook this stirring constantly. And that's just a nice way to introduce heat to our egg yolks so they don't cook. And at this point, you want to turn your heat down to a lower heat. You don't want this to come up to a boil. You just want to let it lightly cook until it thickens. And then as we're stirring this one, we can go ahead, check on our cookies one more time, pop them out of the oven.
Their cookies are super good.
Ooh, good, good. That's what we like to hear. Yeah, those look great over there. And so, the cookies, we're looking just for that golden brown, a little crispiness around the edges, and dryness in the cracks. And then on the stove, we're stirring this eggnog mixture constantly once it goes back. As we're stirring, we don't want to bring it up to a boil. So if you see it starting to come to a boil, go ahead and turn off the heat. We just want to heat till it thickens lightly. And that happens around 185 degrees. This will boil at 200 degrees. You don't have to temperature it. You'll see that it kind of thickens into a light gravy consistency, and that's your sign that your eggs have thickened up and you're good to go. And so I like to stir this pretty constantly with a rubber spatula just until it thickens. The other things you'll look for is it'll get a little steamy in the pot, and that's a sign that it's pretty close to ready to go.
Mom, it's pretty close.
Yeah, definitely steamy, but not yet thickening.
Okay, give it a second. Don't let it come to the simmer. The simmer is where it'll start to curdle because the eggs will cook. So let it just cook until it's nice and thickened lightly. It's better to cook it to the thinner side than to overcook it and curdle it. And so on your pan, as it's getting close, you may also feel a little like bubbles on the bottom of the pan, like as it's feeling like it's close to simmering. So on my spatula at the end, I can kind of feel it starting to simmer a little bit. It's getting steamy and it'll just lightly thicken.
Did you just put your...
And it goes from runny to thicken in like an instant. It happens pretty like instantaneously. Okay, yeah, it looks like you're getting close over there. Just keep it stirring. And it'll thicken up over there, over at Ismail. And getting like perfectly cooked eggnog is the hardest part. So that's where things can go wrong. So just keep it stirring, keep it moving. And Team Elaine's, how's the eggnog looking over there?
Pretty good. Hold on, let me just
think.
All right, what do we think? Do we want gold or dark rum?
Just... Ooh, I would go dark rum. I'm a dark rum person. Yeah. I think the dark rum. Oh, yeah. And Elaine, that's starting to look really good. Okay. And so, mine, I've been stirring a while. It's still a little thin. I'm going to turn my heat up just a hair, but I'm just going to watch it as I turn up that heat. Just make sure it does not boil on that heat. I'm giving it another little bit, and you can see it's kind of starting to ripple in there, get a little bit thicker. It doesn't get ultra thick, but just a little bit thicker. The other test you can do is if you dip a spoon in there, it'll coat the back of that spoon beautifully, and you can run your finger across, and it'll leave a little line in that.
My finger across what?
Okay. So you dip a spoon in your eggnog, and when it's thick enough, it'll coat that spoon, and you can draw a line across the spoon, and it'll hold the line. So that's how you know it's thickened. So if it's not running off that spoon, and then when you draw that line with your finger, it kind of holds the line.
I'll try the bottom. I'll try the bottom.
Holding the line.
That's holding it, for sure.
Oh, perfect. Yeah, and so as long as it's lightly thickened and it holds that line, your nog is good to go. You can add in your vanilla extract.
Both of them?
Yes.
Yes, both of them over there. And so, Ariane over there and Ismail, is it starting to get that thickness to it?
It's starting to get there. It's not quite thick enough yet.
Okay. And it is just a fine line of keeps going and it gets to that point. I like to do it slowly just to make sure we don't like pass the point and get those curdles. Nog anytime. If you ever notice curdles in it, you can strain those out with a fine mesh strainer. It's just little eggy bits and they'll come right out, or you can whisk them out. And so we got that nice thickness. I went ahead and took this off the heat, and that is our eggnog. And so eggnog is also an ice cream base. It's made the same way you'd make a French style ice cream. And so if you wanted, you could turn this into an eggnog ice cream by putting it in an ice cream maker once it's chilled. Yeah, just a little fun fact I like to share. And so, we've got our nice eggnog coming together. We've got gingerbread cookies. And it is almost time to serve and enjoy. As you're ready to go, even if your nog's not, I recommend taking a cookie and dipping it in the nog while you're cooking it so you can get a little taste of your cookie and nog.
I
taste
eggnog with the cookie.
Maybe oh, sure.
So here, let me put it in a pot.
And just have a little chef snack, a little chef taste over here. And so we are ready to serve once that nog's thickened. And so
I'll be right back.
Okay, you'll be right back. Perfect. I don't ever really spike my nog itself. I like to save it and then add my spirit as I serve it, so serving it with the spirit in it. But I've heard if you add the spirit directly to the nog, it lasts for much longer. Like, people have told me they've saved their nog for a year because they put so much alcohol in it. And I was like, I've never tried that. I don't know how valid that is, but if you want to save your nog for a long time, that might be a way to go.
Okay, sorry.
And so, Is our nog thickening over there? Are you seeing the
back totally thick.
Oh, good.
I came out of this hat.
Yeah.
Oh, you came out of that hat? I saw that, Shepherd.
Get in the eggnog and try it.
Yeah. No. And so once we've got that thickness, you can serve this. Dip your cookies in your nog. Try that out.
This eggnog is pretty good.
Okay, good. I'm happy we're getting the approval over there, Chef Bird.
I'm not kidding.
Hannah, how do we like the eggnog?
I can eat this whole half of this cookie right now.
Oh, good. Oh, you just did. Oh, we've got Hannah liking eggnog over there. Is that good stuff? Okay, good. And so I serve this up. And I don't think there is too much spirit you can add to this. So add to your perfect ratio with spirit in there. I know we're going some dark rum at Ismael's. Elaine, are you adding anything to your nog over there?
No, I've got children. Okay, here, go ahead, guys.
Okay. And so we'll go in. Add your little love. And we've got our nog and our cookies. It is a delicious way to spend. The nog lasts about 7 days in the fridge. The cookie dough lasts pretty for like 7 days as well, as long as you bake that off.
Right,
and then how's our nog looking over at Arian and Ismael's?
It's almost there, I would say.
Okay.
I'm trying to turn the heat up a little bit, so it's getting thicker quicker now.
Okay, perfect. Yeah, it's like that fine line. It's so hard to like get that balance, but once you get it, you got that nog, and it is so, so good.
I'm getting the second round of cookies going.
Ooh, good. Yeah, so you've got cookies. It makes around 18 cookies.
Oh, man, like eggnog?
Over a pint of nog, so you've got a little room to party.
Here. No, we're gingerbread cookies.
And these gingerbread cookies, they're like my favorite kind because they have that nice chewiness to them. They're pretty flexible in there. So you get a really nice, chewy, flexible cookie.
Okay, let's
save the cookies that we can cut into shapes.
Oh, next up you're doing the cookies that you can cut into shapes?
If I put whiskey in it, how much do I put? I'm going to give it to my sister.
I would do like a shot for a mug, but I like it pretty strong. So it's up to your like personal taste preferences.
Two shots then. I'm just kidding.
Okay, yeah. If you need two shots over there, you can go in two shots. Personal preference.
Of course,
Carly. I can't
do
all that. This is for my mom. Because I know she likes
eggnog. Yeah. And it is nice with that little whiskey rum. Someone was telling me they do bourbon and rum in theirs all the time. I was like, ooh, if you want a double take over there. And so, thank you for joining, you guys. Good cookie dough going on. And how did your cookies turn out over there, Ismael? I didn't see the cookies.
They look good. I haven't had them yet.
Ooh! I like to dip them in the nog as I'm cooking it to get that nice cookie and nog taste.
Give this to your mom. What is that? Where are you putting that in? Why did you bring that with you?
You wanted to let my mom take, so you didn't know that.
Once it thickens, we add the vanilla extract.
Yeah, add the vanilla extract, and then you can add the spirit to the pot itself, or just add it as you serve it.
I know what happens in the cup that I gave you, or not that you had before.
The one.
Yeah, and the vanilla really finishes it through, brings it all together. It is just spectacular.
We have all of this, right? The whole vanilla extract?
Yeah, all of the vanilla extract. I like it nice and strong in vanilla. It adds a really, really beautiful flavor.
You don't want it anymore? Okay, then you
That smells like whiskey.
No. It smells like whiskey? It
smells like whiskey.
What? Oh my god. Oh, that was the wrong one.
Wait, you drink eggnog chilled or hot? Which is
you can drink it hot, cold, anyway. Yeah. So when I make a pot, I like to drink it warm out of the pot, and then any leftovers, I'll chill it, and I'll drink it cold, and it's delicious both ways. Yeah, and it changes flavor. As you store the eggnog, I leave my cinnamon stick in that eggnog. I'll continue infusing that cinnamony flavor into there. So it's nice to store it with that cinnamon. Yeah, and I want to know, how is it tasting? Do we like the homemade nog? I
like it.
She likes
it. It's got a moon over here.
Ooh, good stuff. Good stuff. Yeah, and so that is our holiday cookies and nog.
Oh my god, this is incredible.
Yes. Yeah. It is so good. I was very much not a nog fan, and then I started homemaking it, and I was like, okay, I understand. I get the nog now. So it is so just good. Spectacular.
I don't know. I'm just not a milk fan in general, so I can't.
You have to taste it. Taste it.
I can dip it. So I just can't.
Good.
Any type of milk makes me I just can't, I guess.
Okay, that's fair. That's fair. Yeah, I'm a milk person. Nog is very dairy forward.
I mean,
yeah, it's real. Dip the cookies in there. Try it with the cookie dipped in the nog.
Oh, yeah, I'm about to. I'm about to
pour it. Okay. Ooh, perfect. Mm-hmm. And then, as I was saying, you can make ice cream with this if you wanted to put the nog in an ice cream freezer. You make eggnog ice cream. And then you can make eggnog and gingerbread ice cream sandwiches.
Oh, man.
Wow.
Yeah, yeah.
It's good.
I'll
do one. What?
It tastes so good. I made one into a ninja.
Whoa. Oh, you bit it into a ninja. We got our ninja cookie and nog. Awesome.
Put this in the fridge.
Thank you guys so much for hopping on and cooking along with us. It has been an absolute blast. And I hope you enjoy your holiday cookies.
Thank you so much. I'm so excited.
Thank you.
Good. You're very welcome. Yeah, enjoy. And this recipe is like your arsenal. Yeah, cheers over there.
Cheers.
Do you think send us an email, Jesse, so we can print the paper out to see what we can use it to make for next Christmas?
Oh, you want the recipe so you can make these next Christmas?
I have the recipe, sweetheart. It's right here.
Okay.
Ooh. Yeah, save that one. And yeah, Chef Burke, next year you can be like, Mom, we got to make the gingerbread cookies and the nog. Ooh, yes. So
I have this cookie dough left, so I can wrap it up for I didn't put it in the fridge, like you said, in the beginning. I wrap it up in do I roll it up in a ball? You say?
I would say, I'll show you. I've got a little excess dough in a little piece of syringe wrap. I'll press it into a little disc. So any excess dough, I like to put in my saran wrap. And this is if I want to do cutout cookies. Mm-hmm. But I'll put it in my little saran wrap and press it into a disc that's about a half inch.
It's an actual gingerbread man.
And then just wrap it tightly, and it goes right in the fridge.
Oh, I made an actual gingerbread man!
And I like to do it nice and thin so that as I roll it out, there's less rolling to do. So a nice, thin packet.
I was coming here?
No.
And then you just pop it in the fridge, chill it till it's firm, and you're good to go.
Okay.
And so...
We did.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Have a beautiful holiday season. And know that if you have questions about anything, you can email me, jeremy@truffleshufflesf.com, and I'm happy to answer any questions. But enjoy your cookies and nog.
Thank you. Bye.
Have a good night.
Good night.